What's up, guys? Welcome to G Whiskey. My name is Jeff. Now, this is a channel where I offer my thoughts and opinions on a specific whiskey, and if you stick around to the end, I'll be giving it a score as well. That sounds interesting. Hit subscribe down below. And with that out of the way, why don't we jump into our review? Today, we're looking at the Aberlour Abana. Stick around. All right, so we're looking at Aberlour Abana today. This is my second time reviewing this one. The last time I looked at it, I believe it was batch 67. I liked it. I gave it a good score. I think it was something like 86. Solid, but not my favorite of the batches. So let's see if there's any difference between that one and the one we're looking at today. Today we've got batch 69.
Don't say it.
Nice. I'm sure you guys all know this one. It's a classic sherry bomb. It's been around for ages. Massive flavors. Bit of a legend among us sherry loving peoples. Comes out in batches. It's one of the OG cask strength batch released whiskeys. This one was a game changer when it first came out. It rode a wave of goodwill and good reception for an extremely long time. It's still a well-received whiskey. It's still a big-time whiskey. I believe either this or the 12-year-old is going to be Aberlour's top-selling whiskey. Not sure which. So still very much a big-time whiskey, although arguably not quite as famous as it once was. A lot of people have made the case that Abanas aren't as good as they used to be, and I'm one of those people. I do think they used to be better. I first got started with batches in the early 40s, and those ones were darker, richer, and I believe older. The new versions, still good. You're still in for like a powerful, intense, punchy hit of sherry, but yeah, they don't have the depth and complexity of those old ones. They're a little bit simpler and a little bit younger. But that's not to say that they're all bad. There's still quite a bit of batch variation among the modern batches. Some of them are genuinely excellent. Others tend to hold up to a certain standard, although they might be a little bit forgettable. But generally speaking, if you're a fan of the Abana flavor profile, it is a bottle worth revisiting from time to time. Anyway, I'm sure you guys already know this, but this is a no age stated whiskey, matured in Oloroso sherry butts, and yeah, why don't we jump into a review, see what our whiskey is all about, and in the meantime, if you could kindly leave a like down below, that'd be greatly appreciated. So this one's cask strength, of course, comes in at 61.2% ABV, so hefty. It's going to be non-chill filtered, it's going to be naturally colored, all the good stuff. Beautiful natural color to our whiskey. If you guys have seen my other Aberlour reviews, you know that I absolutely love these bottles, especially the new ones. I think they've got a sharp look. We have like the seemingly handwritten notes here, the torn label. I love this aesthetic. Presentation score is going to be 5 out of 5. It does say it's non-chill filtered. We have the batch number here. It's pretty bare bones beyond that. It does say it's matured in Oloroso sherry butts, so always appreciate a bit of production information. Not much else to say here. Great looking bottle. Let's try our nose. This has been watered, by the way. Okay, classic. Classic modern Abana nose. Huge sherry, huge red fruits. We have plums, cinnamon, black pepper, oak, earth, autumn leaves, and blackberry jam. Now the palate. Wow. Big, intense hit of spice here. Pepper, deep red fruits, fruit compote, mulled wine. We've got fruit skins, plums, blackberries, grape skins, sultanas, and some oak. Now we're finished. Okay, cranberry, mulled wine, raisins, cinnamon, earth, some berry jam, some strawberry jam, there's some lingering baking spices. This is a long finish with medium intensity. All right, so we are getting what we sign up for here. You know, even with all the batch variation that happens with this whiskey, there is a general theme that runs throughout the majority of the expressions that's generally pretty reliable. And this one delivers on everything you'd expect from a good bottle of Abana. I'll start off by saying that of course this one isn't as good as like the classic batches from 10 years ago, but you know, obviously that's not fair. When we're looking at a modern version of Abana, we should be comparing it to its modern counterparts, and in that context, we're looking at a pretty solid modern batch here. So yeah, I'm digging the 69, baby. All right, I'm done with the 69 stuff.
That's what she said.
So yeah, it's good stuff. It's good whiskey. I do think that the flavors that we get in here are better executed than they are in a lot of other modern batches of Aberlour. The highlight for me here is the spices. They're just right. They're like big and explosive, but they never burn. The same could be said for the alcohol in this. Big explosive flavors, but no burn to it. So really, this whiskey could be a lot rougher than it actually is. So credit to Graham Cruikshank, who's Aberlour's master distiller. Yeah, for something that's composed mostly of young whiskey, this one doesn't really fall victim to the shortcomings of that youth. Overall, it's a whiskey that works, and it's one that's legitimately fun to drink. But you know, I'll admit, even the better batches of modern Aberlour don't really light my fire like they used to. But still, I'm enjoying every sip of this stuff. I do think maybe if I was a little bit earlier on in my like whiskey journey, or maybe if I didn't have the memory of those older batches stuck in my head. And I don't know, maybe if I was just less jaded as a human, I'd get more excited by this one. As it stands, I do like it. I think it's a good whiskey. I'm going to give it a solid 87. I like this more than the last batch I reviewed, which was batch 67. I prefer the spiciness in this one. This one's still a must for sherry lovers, a group of which I'm most certainly a member, and really, just don't listen to me when I bitch and moan about how this used to be better back in the day. It's still really good now. It's still definitely worth checking out. So yeah. On an unrelated note, this makes a great Christmas whiskey, so I'm going to try and hold on to what's left in my bottle until the Christmas season rolls around. Might make a great gift. Really nice Christmassy flavors in here. Anyway, yeah, everything is in its right place with this one. If you haven't had an Aberlour before, what are you waiting for? Go grab one. If you have had Aberlours, if you're familiar with them, I can tell you that our batch 69 here is one of the better recent ones. So, good stuff, worth checking out. Pretty good value on this one. Where I live, it's pretty affordable. I think most people can and do buy it at a reasonable price. However, it is uncharacteristically expensive on a lot of the big online retailers. From what people tell me though, it tends to be a little bit cheaper in the shops. Anyway, as I said earlier, this is required reading for your sherry lovers out there. It's got big flavors, it's big fun, naturally presented, reasonable price. What else can you ask for? So, recommended. Alright, that's it for me today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If you'd like to help support the channel, please consider becoming a patron. As usual, like, comment, subscribe. I do want to hear from you. Have you tried our Aberlour Aberlour Batch 69? If not, what other batches have you tried that are recent? And finally, down in the comments, let me know what you want to see me review next. I'll keep it in mind for my upcoming videos. Bye, guys.